Hey, another figure review here at FLYGUY.net. We're on the Wave 2 Vintage Collection, which is hitting stores here for us in Australia and across the USA, so it should be coming to stores near you, wherever you are. One figure which I was really looking forward to, and I'm a huge clones, Stormtroopers, Boba Fett, Mandalorians kind of fan, so the Sandtrooper, when it was going to come out, I was really looking forward to. Sadly to say, I'm really disappointed. So this is the guy we're talking about. He originally came out last year, in fact, maybe even earlier this year, on the Jewback pack. So in the film A New Hope, if you remember, there's a very brief scene where the Sandtroopers are seen on these dinosaur-like green lizards called Jewbacks. And there was a Walmart exclusive, I think, earlier this year or previously last year, where this guy came out. Now, he looks identical to previous releases, and the only real difference I can really see is the only real difference to previous Stormtroopers is the ball jointed hips, and that was what made the difference. As he does his dancing, that's what was making the difference in that Jubark release, so he could basically sit on top of that kind of that giant lizard they go doing the splits. So no other troopers could ever really do that without breaking them and have these ball jointed areas. But anyway, let me go on. I'll give you a quick overview of the figure. Let's zoom in for a better look than what I've given you so far. Let's see, here we go. Not working, where are we? There we go. One Vintage Collection Sandtrooper. So, yeah, I'll tell you the reason why I'm not too chuffed about this figure. For one, the Vintage Collection is supposed to be the kind of ultimate of all the figures we've had released before. And I'll compare in a minute, and I'll show you a Sandtrooper from one of my collections behind me. And I'll tell you the reasons why. This is just still not, sadly, the ultimate Sandtrooper. But very quickly, I mean, everything here, articulation-wise, you have a rotating head. It's a little bit stiff, but it does move. Let me take his gun off there just now for a sec, and you'll get to see it a little better. So rotating head, as I mentioned, shoulders, elbows and hands, you have a rotating waist and these hugely ball-jointed hips as we mentioned, knees and moving ankles as well. So pretty articulated overall. Comes with these backpack, which is exactly the same mold as previous backpacks that Hasbro have done. Comes with a pauldron, which has some kind of lines you'll see on there, which I don't think I've seen before. I haven't seen any of these kind of lines on them. But again, he's missing some pieces from previous releases. I'll talk about that again in a sec. No removable helmet. So we're back to the old-fashioned Sandtrooper. I'll take this off. Ball head. So why does the Sandtrooper not really float my boat? Well, let me show you again one of the older, more common releases that was out there. And I'll focus on this guy. So here's one that was released a while back. This guy actually came in, it was a kind of a four pack, I believe, of older figures. And the big plus for this for me was a removable helmet. So that really shouldn't have been a stretch for Hasbro to do that. They could have managed, but for some reason didn't. So I don't know what's going on there. So the ultimate version we have, this new Sandtrooper of the Vintage Collection, does not have this removable helmet, which is pretty annoying. The second thing which I think Hasbro really fallen short on is the pauldron. This pauldron comes with an ammunition pouch if you look at it there and then compare it to this one. Sorry. As you can see, the black kind of hanging down from the pauldron just under the chin. For some reason, this new Vintage Collection guy didn't get one, and I don't know why they didn't. Maybe it's perhaps because they remolded it and added the grooves on there. I'm not quite sure. Maybe it was not as movie articulate accurate as it should be, but they've missed out because, again, we've got a kind of, I think, a better trooper here overall. Okay, he doesn't have the ball-jointed thighs, etc., that allows the jewback, but ultimately, you know, it's not as good. Also missing out on the blaster holder. We don't get that on this guy at all. There's nothing there on him at all, so, again, kind of missing out. One thing that also comes with the older version here is, and it's not such a big deal, but it's the little canister that fits at the back of the thermal detonator that goes in the back of the Sandtrooper. On the new release here, Hasbro have done, let me just take the backpack off to show you, Hasbro have just done this very rough and dirty kind of plastic mold to fill it in, and it just looks crap. It's a shame. This is supposed to be these ultimate figures. I paid $18 for this can. I'm not too chuffed. The other issue is the backpack. Again, if I put this back on, let me show you. So again, this is the new vintage collection. This is supposed to be the superior Sandtrooper. If you look at the detail there on the backpack, and then look at the version that I had previously, you'll see there's actually better paintwork being applied to the older version here. The little silver tips and pieces and a slight silver ring around one of the elements of the backpack. So yet again, I feel as if it's a little bit like Hasbro skimped a little bit and we're getting slightly less detail. It's the same backpack, but again, just applying a little extra paint, a removable helmet, a pauldron with an extra patch. So again, we're kind of left with this guy. What they do make up for is they do supply for the very first time the proper, as far as I can tell anyway, Sandtrooper kind of double barrel. You see this Tommy gun like piece in the middle there, blaster, which I always wanted the Sandtrooper to come with, but Hasbro never did. So that's the biggest plus, is this blaster, which I really love. So I think I'll definitely keep this piece. It's one of the most movie accurate, I think, that I've seen, a movie prop accurate Sandtrooper weapon. So quite a cool piece there. It also comes with a generic kind of Sandtrooper rifle, which I think is fairly movie accurate. But we've had this released so many times in so many different variations for figures. And the big problem with both of these blasters is, and again this new figure, I'm trying to show you all together, is that none of these blasters fit particularly well in the hands of this new trooper. They haven't modified the hands in any way. In fact, they're worse. The older figure can actually accommodate these with a little force. But this guy is just not cutting the mustard for me. So, real letdown considering some of the amazing stuff that's been released in the vintage collection so far. And considering this was a trooper and many people will buy this, I was a little let down. So, sorry Hasbro, you kind of sucked on this one. I don't know what you did. I guess they have to make some kind of save some money here and there in different places and repack bits and pieces. But yet again, this is one good line that you're supposed to be investing a lot of money in. So a bit of a letdown here. Really kind of disappointed in that one. But there we go. Not the best Sandtrooper in the world that I've seen. Some of the better ones exist out there. So hopefully this review might save some of you some money, unlike me. And you can manage to go into eBay and dig out some of the older Sandtroopers like this guy with removable helmet and little bits of detailing and extras and whatnot on there. Just as posable, just as good. The only problem is obviously the biggest selling point seems to be on this guy, the crazy dancer kind of thighs, etc. So so there we go, another review. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope that saves you some money out there. And subscribe and leave some comments, and we will see you again soon. Cheers.